But some people went to negotiate with them. Whenever the kidnapped, some people went to negotiate with them. And I saw these people.
They open rooms for negotiation. But I keep asking, who are these people negotiating these things? How do you get to them? How do you transfer this money? How do you receive back these people? Why not follow up that means and stop this thing? It's easy. We're doing things as if it's never going to end.
That's why you say that there is a link with government.
There is a link from the people that can bring out money for these people, from the people that can negotiate the release. There is a link. Is it difficult for us to trace it? We are saying River State is tired. Niger Delta is tired of the killing. It's our own people that have been killed. Now they are even kidnapping their own people. The same people you're saying have been oppressed. You're trying to let the world know these people have been oppressed. You kidnap them. You kidnap your own people. It is evil. It is evil. This is worse than Sodom and Gomorrah. But we are saying Elijah Sari is God sent to that generation. The mistake the government made was to arrest him. For whatever reason, I think they failed. They arrest him so they can have a way to amend constitution because he will come against it when it is not right. They arrested him so they can have their way in rigging elections. They failed because it is not right. I said it before Obasanjo handed over to the present government. I have always said it. Obasanjo did not give us Yar'Adua and good luck. It was God's intervention to give us good men. We better appreciate and notice that one quick before it gets out of hand. The Bible says when the righteous rule, I repeat, who is righteous? It says, he that practiceth righteousness is righteous. These two men, practically speaking, are trying to practice righteousness. We must let the world know that we have good leaders. Our people must know that we have hope so we can move on. What I'm saying is, most of these people carrying guns are never told they can be loved, they can be useful, they can marry and have a family. Throughout almost 2 years, Alhaji was in prison. I have not seen any Bible preacher from anywhere come address these Niger Delta issues, give these people hope, say, look, you can live a better life. I have just always been there. Trying to negotiate them and see life, let them see life as it is, that your life can be more meaningful. The government of River State, the past one, destroyed something that would have been a platform for a perfect change in River State. 2005, after this crisis in the Niger Delta, when they came to kill Sari, his people resisted it and whatever, Ateke got involved, everybody got involved, the federal government got involved. Over 700 young men and women were sent to Jos for training, for leadership training. They went there, they got trained, came back successfully. If you see them, those are groups where people were used against themselves. Some people, you identify them as somebody who killed your brother, who killed your sister. They all came together in Jos. All the group I'm talking about, everybody came together in Jos. Had a common agreement, embraced themselves, eat together, and came back with so much love like a family. The government promised them everything. At the end of the day, they were left just like that. Now the government is saying if you're a cultist in the Niger Delta and you renounce cultists, they will give you 1 million naira. I keep asking, what terrible situation is these people taking us to? This man who have seen so much money in kidnapping, in killing people, and has not invested anything in his life, you want to give him 1 million naira without training him, giving him an education, giving him a sense of direction? You want to give him 1 million naira to boast that he has a million naira and he can mash your head? We're saying, let's face the facts. Why not bring back these people you trained, that has the training, that has left these things? They can check and bring to book these people that are doing these acts. Why worsen the situation for us? They are setting up people to take this position, that position in Niger Delta. For God's sake, who are these people? Who do they need to go to? We are saying these are young men we know. The people that can approach them are not these big men that are in government houses and so on. We have young men like them that has come to rethink and say, this life is just one. The one that died, nobody is acting after them. So many have died. So many are suffering. So we are saying, it is only we, the young people, that can approach our fellow young men that are into this act and tell them, look, we have a future. We have a name. Why would you want the next generation to describe you to your children like I know your father used to be that kidnapper?
So has your group started this move?
We are doing it. Seriously doing it. Last week, I was in Bayelsa for almost 1 week trying to meet everybody I can meet. Tell them to have everything.
And what has the response been?
Beautiful response. Okay. Beautiful response. We tell them we cannot protect anybody. I also want to plead to the government. Yes, there are harms in Niger Delta. Right now, they have information about people that have harms. And they go to most of them and arrest them. That will not even solve the problem now. So I want to plead. I want to plead that the government should do something in a hurry. If it is pronouncing forgiveness or pardon for everybody, fix a date for harms to be illegal. As in, if you have it, you're in trouble.
Okay.
So then you can make up a lot of things. Mm. So I want to...
It's a good thing, Sir Kusuma, that your organization, and you in particular, you have started the move of arresting the situation.
Yes.
We want to keep a tab on that. And we want to look forward to seeing you back here on Kakaki after a period of time to give us an update, a progress report kind of, on what your organization is doing and you yourself are doing to reduce the situation.
God will help us because right now I think God has taken the affairs of Rivers State and Niger Delta.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Mr. Arokosima Onagia is a spokesman of the Niger Delta People's Salvation Front and political aide to Asare Dokubo. Joining us here on Kakaki, the African Voice, to talk about solution to the problems in the Niger Delta, particularly the problems of kidnapping and hostage taking, which he says it is not the hand. For the rising equity and justice of that part of Nigeria. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Kakaki continues shortly. Stay with us.